Hello YouTube, this is Alexander again. Today I would like to share a project I had since a long time now. It's to build a homemade car amplifier. Nowadays, amplifiers are not so rare and so expensive, and you can find very nice and loud amplifiers for not a very expensive price. So you can wondering why build an amplifier? Of course, build something for saving money is not worth today. So you can understand then this made is for to develop electronic project, try to improve your knowledge and try to conjugate several different science with it. This device is not so easy to build because it requires to you knowledge on many matters, including switching power supply, electromagnetic effects, transformers, and toroidal cores, the pulse width modulation mode called in French MLE pour modulation de largeur d'impulsion. Of course, we need some prerequisites to understand what we need, especially because this project is made with a lot of recovered parts, including toroidal and bipolar or a MOSFET amplifier. A car amplifier includes two main parts. The first part is the power supply, which are very important and which is the hardest part to make. After this, you have the amplifier. I will try my best to use classical components to make it, but as possible, I will try to use recovered parts. The first part here is the toroidal transformer. First of all, it's the choice of the core of the toroidal. You can use an EI core also. This kind of core are specially made for this purpose. The green and gray ones are my favorites because they sometimes work very well. And you can use a toroidal core, but it's very complicated because lots of people think they are identical, while it's not. Toroidal are mainly used in conventional car amplifier because there is a lot of properties and many materials. Toroidal core seems to be identical, but that's not the case. These yellow ones are very strong to use. They are different. There is mainly two kind of core, the ferrite core and the iron powder core. The ferrite core is the common material used for high frequency transformer, while iron powder core are used for filtering DC output against noise coming from switching power supply. It needs to be able to filtering while a huge current going through it. There is again another kind of core which you can find on 8 series amplifier. They provide high saturated flux and are made by nanocrystal magnetic particle. They are called ribbon toroidal. Here I have a tor coming from a little lead amplifier. The permeability of this core is 80 microhenry. This value can be a reference. You will not have less value than this one otherwise. You have to increase wire for to keep a decent frequency switching. The permeability is the way of a material to create an inverted current in the wires, which is opposite to the first current. It creates a retarded current according to the frequency and number of wires, which opposes to the first current. Iron powder core have less permeability than classical ferrite core, but magnetic field created in a powder core is hard to saturate, which provide a high power switching power supply. More the core have a high permeability, less you need the wire on the core, and the frequency of switching is lower than for a powder core. But in powder core, the high frequency needed can provide some loss. Powder core are mainly used when strong current is flowing on the wire to provide a rest of permeability of material to keep filtering. In my case, I recovered lots of toroidal from inverters like this one, but each core need to be measured with an LCR to know its reactance. This tor gives a very nice value, which gives an easy way to rewind. Reactance is important because if you don't know this information, you will destroy your power supply experiment at the first power up. In my case, I will try to make a MOSFET stage amplifier, and I want to recover this power MOSFET you can see here. For the moment, I just intend to do it, but of course, if the specification of these components are not switchable, I will find another way to proceed. I will try to use this MOSFET here, they are very nice, just need to be checked for making the amplifier part. And here I dismounted one of this capacitor, and you can read the different value. They are perfect for this project. The best core here are those ones. They have a very high permeability core, they are made in ferrit and are very well. Be careful with this stuff because this device is not very sharp and it have a bad accuracy. His maximal resolution is about 10 microhenry. In fact, you need an LCR meter to do it right. You can use this kind of wire to make your main transformer. You recognize this, it's a microwave transformer coil which can be recovered for this project. You can use the wire, but tossing on himself with another wire to make a main wire like this one to prevent loss due to the skin effect. These are my favorite toroidal core. I love this one. These black ones have low permeability, which requires you to not use it like a transformer, but maybe only like filtering coil. I am not using them for my project. Those ones are beautiful, but they have a low permeability. They are huge. I will try to test them and see if I can put any frequency for a nice working with. This one are very little, no good here. This one is made by a ribbon metallic shape and it have a very low permeability. Don't use a tor like this. It was used at the origin like a homopolar transformer. Not good for the project. So for the DC-DC inverter of the amplifier, I think I'm gonna use this one or this one and those capacitors which are very nice. You can notice this little capacitor which can be used for filtering DC current before DC-DC inverter. EI transformer comes sometimes from computer power supply, which you can see here completely naked, but it have a huge size beside toroidal. You cannot use the last one because it a different tor, not suitable here for this project. I hope you understand that the choice of the tor is one of the most difficult thing with this project. EI transformer, not naked. Beside a 10 cm ferrite toroidal core. The green is a huge one, large enough, but I didn't test it yet. Those capacitors seems to have the good size, and for sure they are, but they have a low capacitance and high voltage use. They are not suitable here. For to test some toroidal, I wired 4 turns on one of my favorite toroidal core with a special wire. Made by a lot of little wire twisted together. All these wire are not conductive between them, they are colored leads wire, as you can see here. Very beautiful MOSFET here, waiting to be desoldered and tested. This capacitor is perfect to filter DC current before switching. This huge capacitor will be able to filter the high voltage rail before to power the amplifier section. Of course, they need to be tested because they are recovered parts. The little capacitor seems to work well and have a nice ESR, as you can see here. The huge capacitor seems to be nice. I am more interested by the ESR than the capacitor value, and this one seems to work very nice. This black ferrite core is tested too. When you can read the value on the screen, so you can calculate the nice frequency for switching your transformer. Of course, experimenting and testing are the best way to understand how it can be the best way for working. The value displayed is very, very good for this project. This core comes from a real car amplifier with a very medium power. I use this core just like a reference to not exceed the value needed for this project. Don't forget, this part is the most difficult. When wired, you need to have something close to this value. If not, you can add more wires, but there is not much place, so you need to change your core. Here is the green one. The green core are sometimes good ones. The color of the core is sometimes a code for the material of the core. There is a lot of different materials. I can notice that gray and green color are sometimes suitable. As you can see, the value display is very nice. Here you have a lot of MOSFET and you can use it for the amplifier part. You also have capacitors, but I guess they are not the best value for me here. Of course, a device used like a real LCR meter like this one is better. It have more accuracy. Like the same, you can see here from the inverter lots of capacitor with high voltage which can be recovered after a good check. But here, of course, the voltage is very high and it's not exactly the specs we need. Of course, it's not forbidden to buy this component to build this amplifier. For the toroidal, I intend to use copper wire from a wave oven transformer like this one. You probably need to use many wires for to build one wire to make easy the current flowing at high frequency against skin effects of high frequency current switching. This special wire is called Litz wire. In this inverter you can find lots of interesting components like capacitors, MOSFETs, filter, resistors and heatsink. Here you have a low permeability toroidal core. Those ones are mainly for filtering. Here you have EI core used only for like high frequency transformer. This type of core, something with green color, have high permeability and are nice to use for DC-DC inverters. Here you have some MOSFET transistor. Of course, you have to search data sheet for to use it properly. You also can recover the heatsink and the capacitor. In this part, you have a big green toroidal core, which are my favorite for building, a nice heatsink and some MOSFETs. This tor is large and this one is a twin tor. Two tors are used here. Those are for filtering in common or normal mode for filtering. This stuff takes a while to dismount, lots of components are hidden underneath. For this project, I will try to use most recovered part as possible. It was Alexander again. Stay tuned for the rest. See you soon.